then, you know, several years from now, we're going to be doing in Bonfire what you guys were helping us do in Eagle Cave.
And you guys are all invited.
Because this site, I mean, you can see it's been open since the 1960s. And one of the reasonings was it was the archaeologists who dug it wanted people to come back because they knew it was a really cool and important site. But it's been, you know, damaged because it's been open, and we've lost a substantial amount of material. So the best way to preserve that is going to be to sandbag it and backfill it back in.
This wall behind you used to be straight. It used to look like that wall. And that's occurred in, you know, just a matter of 35 years. That'll happen.
Yeah. Natural cave off, runoff.
Right. Type. With really hard rain, you get water that runs all the way in through the northern end of the shelter and also off this slope. And so you can see where it pours off the side right here and in that back corner. So that's what really got Steve and Charles, got their attention as far as needing to do some stabilization out here, and got Skiles interested in taking it on as far as stabilizing it. And then when I came to Texas State, Steve said, you know, there's about a two-year window of opportunity to work at Bonfire Shelter. Would you like to? Yeah, I'd like to. It's right up my alley. So. Yeah. Although I've not worked in a rock shelter before. This time period's right up my alley, but I've not worked in a rock shelter before.
This is a cool place to work.
I've worked on open air sites. It's a learning experience for me, too.
Cool.
Too cool.
What's that?
I said it's too cool.
Yeah, it's definitely pretty damn cool.
I don't know. I prefer out there in the sun at Beeville. What do you think?
Mm-hmm.
They got their own shape here.